In Red Dead Online, there is a ton of room for error as a player. Regardless of your experience, accidents are bound to happen. Some accidents are a lot more common than you may think, and on top of that, they can be pretty hilarious. Hello everyone, I am Zumi Fiasco. Welcome back to another Red Dead Online video. To all of you new visitors out there, big ups for tuning in. I hope you enjoy your visit and maybe even consider joining the Fiasco family by the time this video is over. We are on the road to 50,000 members strong, and there's going to be a big gold bar giveaway at that point, so let's get there soon. Red Dead Online is a pretty challenging experience in itself. You face numerous bugs, glitches, and when you're new, getting the hang of the game's controls and mechanics can feel sloppy and difficult. If you relate to this, you're not alone. We've all been there. Today's video was inspired by the simplicity of accidents, but not just any accidents. Today we are covering the more comical of accidents in Red Dead Online. Ladies and gentlemen, Fiasco family, these are the top 5 funniest accidents made by Red Dead Online players. Alright, here we go, kicking things off with accident number 1. Pissing off NPCs. Getting off on the wrong foot with a non-player character is quite easy in Red Dead Online. So easy that it's annoying, but it can also be pretty funny. For example, a player can simply stand next to an NPC at any location for a few seconds too long, and the NPC will become antagonized. That's right, a player's presence is enough to get them punched in the face. Best part is, if the player hits back, the law will get involved and be gunning for the player, even though they are simply defending themselves. Then, on the other hand, if you don't get hit in the face from the NPC and they simply walk away, they'll report you to the law for standing near them, and then you'll have the law on you trying to shoot you down for standing near them and looking at them the wrong way. Another time a player may accidentally piss off an NPC is when the player tries to simply mount their own horse near an NPC on horseback or driving a wagon, and the player will accidentally rip the NPC off and attempt to steal the horse or wagon they are driving, even though their initial intention was to simply get on their own horse. If the player is unlucky enough, the NPC will be packing a shotgun and bust off a few shots without warning. This accident is hilarious to see from the outside perspective because you know exactly what the player is going through, and now they are getting shot at from multiple angles, accruing a bounty for fighting back with no other option than to flee the scene. Oh, and let's not forget while fleeing or just riding around in general, trampling of NPCs happens pretty often too, almost as if they are trying to get hit by being in your way. Carrying a dead body, lassoing a friend, negative emoting in a crowded area can all piss off an NPC, and most of the time, it's really an accident. Accident number 2, driving a wagon straight off a cliff. This accident is one of the most commonly experienced and hated, but it's also one that players can look back on and laugh at soon after. Whether a player stole a wagon for a joyride or they are using a special wagon to complete a role-specific mission, wagons can be dangerous. In Red Dead Online, when you're riding horseback, there is a bit of a failsafe implemented into the game that causes your horse to rear back when you come up on a cliff that would otherwise mean death if you were to keep moving forward. This has saved me from an annoying death and respawn on multiple occasions. When it comes to wagons though, no such failsafe exists. If a player is smacking those reins and blitzing forward at a high speed, there will be no chance to stop when it's too late, and as a result they will proceed to nosedive straight over the edge of a cliff and most times be hurled to their death. When this happens, on role-specific missions, bounty targets can die, moonshine can be destroyed, and trader supplies can be lost. This accident is never ideal, but it's hilarious. For most players, it takes all of one time for this to happen for them to proceed with caution when traveling with a wagon. As a player, when was the first time you accidentally drove a wagon straight off a cliff? Did you survive? Was it during a role-specific mission? Was it in the story mode? Let's talk about it down in the comments below. No need to be embarrassed, we've all been there. Moving right along to accident number 3, falling off buildings. What about falling off a building isn't funny? I mean, come on. From the hilarious ragdoll animations to the ridiculous in-game character noises that are made in Freefall, it's a comedic art form. It's pure gold. In Red Dead Online, there are numerous occasions where players find themselves on the top of a building. Could be a free roam event, maybe a mission objective, or even just fleeing the law. Regardless though, this accident is probably the most common simply because of how easy it is to do. I find myself hurling my character off a building when I sprint too hard for the ladder and miss it ever so slightly, resulting in death. Leave it to the in-game characters to do absolutely nothing to try and catch themselves either. Whether it's slipping when climbing, diving to avoid gunfire, or making the slightest error in movement near an edge, falling off a building is the one accident all players can laugh at in the moment just because of how simply bizarre the game handles Freefall. The parkour enthusiasts that run the roofs of Saint-Denis and the toxic griefers that stalk their innocent prey from the rooftops of Blackwater know this accident all too well. The griefers will be less likely to own up to it though. Now, if you do find yourself getting bored in Red Dead Online and you decide to stroll across the rooftops of buildings that you have yet to tread on, just be careful and be sure and mind your step. They can be slippery and you may find yourself getting caught in an accident. Accident number 4, players punching or smacking their very own horse. The act of actually punching a horse may not be that funny, it's the fact that the horse retaliates and kicks the shit out of the player and puts them straight on their back. Or if you're like me, in my experience, the first time I punched my horse, you get kicked off a cliff. How did that happen, you might ask? Well, I was looking at a great view, took out my in-game camera to snap a photo, and then I put it away, but I spammed the back out button too many times, and well, I accidentally punched my horse, and it kicked me straight off the cliff. Now, there are times in Red Dead Online that cause a player to get upset with their horse for not cooperating or getting in the way, and in some instances, yes, players will smack their horse on the rear intentionally to get them out of the way or take out their anger. I, for one, just don't have the heart to. I know they are virtual horses, but Rockstar did a phenomenal job on these virtual creatures, and I can't bring myself to just hit my horse because it feels so wrong. Of course, that being said though, there have been times where I and every other player out there have accidentally done this. In Red Dead Online, the same button used to back out of menus is the same button that causes your character to perform a melee strike. You see where I'm going with this? Whether players are browsing the catalog, going through their satchel, or maybe navigating through the online interaction menu, if they are in a hurry to back out while they are standing next to their horse and they start spamming the back button and end up exiting the menu but they are still spamming that same button, the game will register the input as a melee strike and, well, the player commits virtual animal abuse. Then you feel like a jerk. Usually after this accident happens, it's followed up with the horse patting, horse feeding, and horse brushing. Sometimes players will literally apologize to their horse out loud. I know this because I am one of those players. Here we are at the last accident, the final accident on today's list. Accident number 5, players choking out their friends. I mean, if we're all being honest here, sometimes it's intentional and we claim it's an accident, but let me just get into the details of how this actually can be an accident and how it happens. When messing around with melee in Red Dead Online, sometimes a player's input does not result in the desired action. So when players perform crouched stealth attacks on unsuspecting players from behind, typically it results in a one button press execution, and that's to be expected. But there are some times when players simply want to get the attention of another player, or in this case, their friend that they have not posse'd up with yet. Something to note, there is a difference between this and griefing. Typically, griefers will just go straight to the kill. In this case, it can be done on accident. If a player is standing upright, approaches another player, and performs a melee strike, typically the player's character will push the target player, punch the target player in the back of the head, or grab the shoulder of the target player, turn them around, and punch them directly in the face. Sometimes though, in one-off rare occurrences, if a player attempts to hit another player from behind, even though they're standing up straight, the action will be a chokeout instead of a strike. Therefore, the player is going to die and you cannot back out of the chokeout animation until it is completely played out. This results in players accidentally killing their friends all the time, which can lead to hilarious fighting and bickering between players, and they may take some fun out of it. They may have a quick 1v1, or the other player may do something to get back at the player unsuspectingly at a later time and then reference back to when they choked them out saying, "That's what you get, man. That's what you get for choking me out earlier." So, what you need to take away from this, next time you think about hitting someone with their back turned to you, be ready for the chance that you'll accidentally choke them out. Alright everyone, that sums up today's weird video. I had fun making it and I hope it was entertaining to watch. I know Red Dead Online has been in a rough state lately, so my main goal is to try and at least provide you with some relatable, entertaining content. Personally, I can relate to all these things, but I don't know about you. Can you relate to them? Do you have these accidents pretty often in Red Dead Online? And are there any accidents that I missed in this video that you actually go through yourself or you see your friends doing that make you laugh? Let me know down in the comments because I'd love to share a laugh with you over it. Then also, I try my best to heart every single comment, test my skill, test my ability to keep up, and leave some comments down below, and I'll try my best to heart every single one. Also, if you are a new visitor or a returning one that has not subscribed yet, please consider doing so alongside turning on notifications. The last 28 days, over 85% of the views on the channel have been unsubscribed people, which blows my mind. It's pretty crazy, but anyway, if you do consider it, thank you so much. And if you actually do go on to subscribe, welcome to the family. We are on the road to 50,000 members strong, a huge milestone, and I want to smash it soon so I can give away some gold bars and celebrate. I hope to see you all in the next one. Later.